somebody who's watching this video, you're a very like creative person. You are into the arts, whether it be poetry, music. You may write music. You could be someone who's into fashion. You could be into like creating your own movies or something like that. Somebody could be like a writer. Someone could be like a very big dreamer. All right, your creative projects are attached to your emotions. It's like an emotional outlet for you or something like that is what I'm getting here. You could be drawn to things that have like a Greece or Roman look to them, or the architecture over there or something like that is what I'm getting here. Someone also likes to spend time by the beach, by the water. All right, that's significant to someone. I'm also getting here someone likes to wear clothing or prints that have flowers or roses in them, or you may like to have stuff like that in your house. All right, something is significant there. Whoever this message is for, you wear your emotions day to daily and what it is that you put on your body or something like that. Like you do something that represents how you're feeling in the inside in your clothing. Spirit is saying this is a good time for you to take a rest, take a break or something like that. All right, take some time to contemplate. I'm getting here someone could be on the fence about meditation or like practices like that or something like that. For someone, even Buddhism or something. Somewhere where you're going into your mind and you're just giving yourself a rest and a healthy contemplation, where when you leave out of this, you have some type of level of wisdom about yourself, about your surroundings, about you have like a better awareness, all right, is what I'm getting here. So something like that could be significant. I'm even getting here like even when you take this rest, you may be thinking about like everything from your past or something like that. Not to get you too emotional or anything like that, but it's just like you may be thinking and contemplating about things that you've experienced, what you've been through, is what I'm getting here. Someone could even be drawn to Asian prints and things like that, or you could be from Asia. You could have some Asian ancestors or something like that is also what I'm getting here. But I'm getting here really what this is about is a creative person taking some time to just rest your mind, all right, rest your body, rest your spirit. I'm even hearing respect your body. So take a detox from something or take a break from something, and it has to do with something that you may be like all the I hear you may have like a lot of ideas. Someone has like a full mind, all right, of ideas that you could be brainstorming. You may have many options or different things that you like to tap into with your creative energy. All right. I'm getting here. I'm speaking to someone who's like a wise soul. You have very unique ideas or something like that. Of course, you may say everyone has unique ideas because we all have different, you know, ideas that we come up with. But someone who's watching this channel, you are like a unicorn. You are like a one in a million. One in a melon, or you're like a unicorn or something like that is what I'm getting here. You're very different. There's something significant about the way that you look. Your beauty is also significant here. Someone may deal with Beset energy, Beset, all right, Egyptian. I'm hearing Egyptian. I also just heard body sickness. So somebody could have like a very, very beautiful shape or something like that, your body. But I'm getting here, someone has like a beautiful face too, like an Egyptian-like face. It's reminiscent of that is also what I'm getting here. So I'm also getting here, someone could be drawn to cats. Someone may like sunflowers. Someone may like to eat sunflower seeds. You may like to drink sunflower tea. I think they have sunflower tea or something like that. I'm not sure. But someone may like to spend time outside. I'm picking up on like someone's inner child is showing up here. So maybe that's why that rest energy is coming up here. Maybe you've been working so hard at something that, you know, it's time to play a little bit, or it's time to give yourself a little break is what I'm getting here. But I'm getting here, there's a promise to you about your health. All right. Someone could even be a healer, a medicine woman, or a medicine man that's watching my channel. You could be someone who deals with the herbs, plants, teas and tinctures and things like that. Maybe you like to make your own is what I'm getting here. You are some type of promise or contract or vow is being made to you about your healing abilities. All right. I'm also getting here. Someone may be fearful. Someone's fearful. I don't know if this is you that's watching this video or this is someone else. So we're going to tap into this a little bit more in just a second here. But I'm getting here that somebody is like, I'm getting here someone saying like, please. this somebody got somebody on their mind a lot is also what I'm hearing, because I just heard a song in my head. I'm hearing day and night. Okay, so something, this could be also connected to your love life or something like that. Take it how it resonates, because we do have the love life card right here, y'all. All right, roses is here again. So like I said, someone could be drawn into flowers. Someone likes roses or the prints or something like that in their clothing. Or you like that in the like floral stuff in your designs or something like that. You may even be someone who creates stuff like that. I'm hearing you're going to have like, someone's in a period where they're having like fulfillment in their relationship, like their love life. If this is not where you're at right now, you're going to be here soon, because it's like someone has like so much fulfillment. They're like happy with where they're at. And this is on some like, I couldn't have wished for this to be any better. This is almost like when you get with someone and you lock in with each other and you're starting to plan things together and you're actually doing things together and you're getting close to planning like, okay, let's start a family. Let's buy a house together or something like that. That's the energy I'm picking up on for someone. So take it how it resonates, because that's not going to be everyone's message, but that's what I'm picking up on for someone. But there is some type of fearful energy I'm picking up here. I hope this is not like cold feet or something, but we're gonna do a couple more cards here and see what this is. I'm going to do some other cards just as clarifiers. Someone could be a Scorpio, Cancer, or a Pisces. Someone could also be a Leo. All right. I could be talking to those signs. It doesn't have to be that exactly, but that's what I'm picking up on here. Someone is definitely a dreamer, an imagination type of person. I'm hearing imagination. somebody has like this fantasies. Oh, somebody could even write fantasies. Something about fantasies or sci-fi or mystical or what is the other one? Something like that. It's something else I was thinking of. But there's someone who's like in the fantasy world. Like you have so many creative ideas. You have so many different things that you're doing or that's coming to the surface within you that you may need to put these into some type of creative projects, or you could just do them for fun, for hobbies. But I'm getting here, you do also need to take a break. You also need to rest your mind, all right? So let's get some clarifiers here, because I want to see what these energies is. Why is this energy of something? Oh, something could be coming in to disrupt something. But I'm hearing that's because something needs to be reset. Somebody could even deal with like anxiety or something like that too, is what I'm picking up on. So just a second here. All right, let's see. What is this about? I just heard all around the world. Somebody could be a traveler and they feel like I've been in a lot of places, but I still haven't met my person, or I still haven't found this person that I dream of or something like that. Someone may dream of their person, because I just heard a song. Okay. Yeah, so somebody, you are someone who is very passionate about the things that you create. All right, you are very like fired up about the things that you create, charged up. You could be like an energizer bunny, like you just never turn off when it comes to creative ideas or something like that. They're constantly flowing through you. Somebody's thinking about coming together with you, or somebody, you could be thinking about having like an outing with your friends. Maybe that could be your rest, like your break day. The day that you kind of just take a breather is when you go hang out like with some friends or something like that. Y'all may go out to eat, or y'all may go out to something y'all like to do. All right. Yeah. Someone could even want to take you somewhere and treat you, or just like balance something out as far as like, I'm getting like a giving energy or a harmony energy. I'm getting here. If you take your rest days, or you take your break or something like that, you're going to have more harmony on your work days, or you're going to have more like enjoyment and fulfillment on the days that you are creating. Something about that is significant here. All right. Somebody could be gathering up something as well as what I'm getting here, putting some things together. Somebody could be like gathering their resources together for something. Maybe somebody's thinking about this. This could be a friend, or this is just someone. Threes is significant here. Someone's gathering up something, all right? Or they're thinking about this is what I'm getting here. All right. Hmm. Swans could be significant. All right. Somebody could be an Aquarius. Is also what I'm picking up on here. Somebody's like a star, or they're well known, or they're like a celebrity. This is giving someone who gets like a lot of attention or something like that. Someone may get a lot of attention because of their creative ideas or something like that. People are drawn to you because of the things that you create, or you come out of the clouds with, or something like that is what I'm getting here. Someone shines, like you stand out. Remember I was saying someone's like a unicorn? That's what it is. Someone's like a unicorn because they're like a, there's someone, if you're working on something and you're putting it out to the public, something may go very much viral or go big because you are different. Something that you do, you're very different at it. All right. So someone is a healer. Someone's like a healing man or woman. You could be in isolation, or you could go into isolation sometimes just to preserve yourself. Cause I'm getting like the energy of what they put on mummies in Egyptian times or something like that to preserve the body. Something like that is significant here. I don't know what that's called, or I forgot what it's called, but something like that is significant here. If someone's into working with candles, I'm getting here like a yellow candle would be good for you, like a radiant candle or a shining candle. Yellows and oranges is significant for you, or wearing those colors. Like I said earlier, sunflowers is significant here. You may like to put some sunflowers in your home or something like that. But I'm getting here, someone's like, there's a promise that you're going to be healed by going with, oh, that's what spirit is saying. There's a promise that the person who this message is for is going to like receive some type of renewal. Like your skin is going to look better when you take this break or something like that, or when you take your rest, or if you work with sunflower herbs or teas or something like that. Tinctures. Some promise is being made to you. Also, you may be like honoring some promise of being a healer. But I'm getting here like you are aligning your chakras at this time, purifying your energy or something like that. I'm also getting like a smoke. What is it called? A smoking, purifying cleanse or something like that. Some of y'all have some type of support of your ancestors. And they are causing some type of tower in your life, but this is for the good. Someone could also be very fearful of like something with a house situation happening. Oh, somebody don't want to feel like an outcast is also what I'm getting here. But spirit is saying like, don't worry about that, because you're supposed to stand out. You're supposed to be different. You're supposed to be like unique. Like you're not supposed to do what everybody else do. You're not supposed to do it the same way as everybody else, because you're supposed to stand out. Someone could be like having a fear of being an outcast, or like your family not supporting you or something like that. I'm getting here, they are going to support you if there's something that you had in mind while you're watching this video. Also, someone could have like potential people looking at your relationship or something like that. Like you're at a place of fulfillment with your relationship, and you can have people that's paying attention to that. So be mindful of that is what I'm getting here too. All right. People who are like overlooking your love life, they see that you're happy or you're fulfilled or something like that is what I'm getting here. Yeah. Oh, you could be getting clarity. Like somebody's getting clarity on like their partner, their lover or something like that, or just finding out like some type of truth about their lover. Why is that energy here, spirit? Karma. Somebody's dealing with some karma. This could be a soulmate or some type of soul contract you have with somebody. Somebody's dealing with some karma, but I don't know. I feel like if somebody was dealing with like a third party or something like that, that person could be dealing with some karma while you're getting some type of fulfillment, or you're just going to be, somebody put themselves in a dangerous situation. This is not going to be for everybody for this small part, spirit is telling me, but I'm getting here of someone who have like, by dealing with like third parties or multiple women or men, somebody put themselves in a dangerous situation where they couldn't see clearly because it had too many people around them, too much confusion. It had too many ingredients in a pot is what I'm getting here. So they was making it hard. Oh, yeah. So now this person is enslaved to whatever they chose. But let's get back to you. Two of Earth. Yeah. Ooh, baby. Okay. You're going through some type of renewal. Somebody is watching the channel. You're going through like a physical rebirth or something like that. You're going to be looking more better. All right. Like you're going to be looking more gooder than, I don't know, that's not a word. Like, you're going to be looking really, really, like, it's like, if you look good already, you're going to be looking even better next time somebody see you, or just in general. Yeah, that's what I'm getting here. Set boundaries with people that you've already walked away from, all right? Because those people could be dealing with karma or something like that, and just keep on living your life, shoot. All right, so I'm done with this reading. I'm going to do another one.